blessing over every person that's in this facility. You know, the Bible tells us that where two or more are gathered, he's present. And that he will answer us when we call him. So here we go. Father, we just want to thank you so much to the medical community that is right here before us. We're asking that you would place your hands of protection over every single wing of this facility. I pray first, Lord, over all of the EVS workers, Lord, those that are sanitizing and cleaning and keeping us safe. Lord, they're working tirelessly to keep this virus at bay. They are truly the unsung heroes. They can be overlooked so easily, but Lord, we know that you see them. So Father, over every individual in this facility, in this hospital, that is taking care and sanitizing and cleaning and seems to go unnoticed, I know that you notice them, Lord. So I ask that you would bless them and protect them, that you would keep them safe first and foremost, Lord. Because if they can't do their job, this hospital gets shut down. So Father, we ask you to bless every single individual that is bringing the sanitization of this facility. I ask that you would bless them truly from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. We pray, Lord, over the maintenance people who are keeping the building up and running. I can't imagine with the nonstop usage of every piece of equipment that is taking place and the stress that takes place as a result of it. Lord, we ask that you would watch over all of the maintenance individuals, the supply people that are managing the constant nonstop ordering of equipment and the necessary things that are currently keeping people alive as we speak. Then, Lord, we pray over all of the CNAs and the LVNs. Lord, they're working around the clock doing the brush work. They're cleaning and sitting with and caring for and crying along with the family members that are here in this room or the patients that are in the room. They're doing the hard stuff, Father. I'm asking that you too would protect them. Let nothing come against them, Lord. Not a single thing would penetrate them, Lord, that they would not get sick as a result of caring for all of the others. And then, Lord, we pray over these nurses. Father, every single nurse that is in this facility right now, I'm asking, Lord, for your goodness. I'm asking, Lord, for courage beyond measure. I'm asking for strength that would blow them away. Lord, they are weary.
Yes, they are. Father. They're tired.
But we see them. We see them putting their lives on the line. We see them putting people before themselves. We see them putting others before their very own even families, Lord. We see them at the end of the day when they're so exhausted, Lord, and they've got nothing else to give, and they give another day. Father,
that's
in
right.
The name of Jesus Christ, I am asking that your overwhelming goodness would bless the nurses in this hospital right now.
Yes.
That they would know that their community is for them. That they are there to support them, that we appreciate them, Lord, would they know that they are honored and valued. I pray, Lord, that you would truly protect them and their families, that when they leave this place, nothing will stick to them.
That's right.
Any person that walks out of this door, nothing will stick to them, that they would not go home with a single thing on their body that could cause more damage to their own families.
That's right.
I pray, Lord, over the medical doctors that are here, that are providing the care, that are doing whatever is necessary. I pray, wisdom, Lord, would you give every physician a supernatural amount of wisdom to attack what is coming at us in this world? Would they know what to do when they don't even know what to do? I pray for supernatural strength.
Yes.
Because they too, Lord, are tired.
Yes, they're exhausted.
And then, Lord, we pray over the family of every single staff person that is in this facility. They too, Lord, are paying a price for this. They too may not work in this facility, but they are as much a part of the healing in this community as the medical professional themselves, because they're missing their family members. They're missing out on gatherings and get-togethers.
Yes.
And I know, Lord, that many of them are saying, we can't be together this year.
That's right.
Because the price they have to pay.
Yes.
To be here, to care for the community. and watch more. Because you're a good God and you have good intentions. In the name of Jesus Christ, Jesus. The only name that has power, say amen and amen.
Thank you.
Yes.
Lord, I can't imagine the heartache and the setback and the devastation that goes from room to room to room. Lord, we're asking right now that every single individual that is laying in a hospital bed.
That's right.
They're laying on a gurney in the hallway. They're wondering what their tomorrow looks like.
That's right.
I pray, Lord, that you would bring healing to their bodies.
That's right.
I pray that you, the God of all creation, who says, I am your healer, would today be the healer of so many people that are in these four walls, Lord.
Yes, Father.
I'm asking that you would truly send your angels to encamp over each and every bed.
Right.
Every person, every Lord, that represents a family and a generation. I'm asking that you would bring healing. I pray over those individuals that are on ventilation machines
as
we speak, Lord, and trying desperately to breathe, that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you would breathe into those lungs. That where there was devastation and despair, you, Lord, will bring hope and healing.
Yes, hope and healing.
I pray, Lord,
hope
over the beds. I pray, Lord, over every single solitary patient.
Hope and healing.
That the blood of Jesus Christ would cover them. I pray, Lord, against despair and depression.
Yes, in Jesus'
name. For those
name.
That are isolated because they have
yes.
no contact with family members, Lord.
Yes.
I pray that today there would be a renewed hope in them. That you would give them this idea that there is more tomorrow to come. That tomorrow will be brighter than today. I pray against hopelessness in the name of hope. I pray against despair. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray against isolation. I pray against depression. I pray against any enemy, foreign or domestic, that wants to come and attack the mental state of every patient that is isolated as we speak. I pray against the enemy that wants to take their life. We speak life into dry bones today, Lord, because you said we could. You said, Lord, that we had power to literally raise folks from the dead. Lord, we're believing you today that you, Lord, can speak life into these circumstances today. And where there is no hope in some of these patients, Lord, that you will renew their strength. And they really will mount up on wings like eagles, Lord. That you will bring them a better tomorrow, Father. That you will bring them the healing that is promised. And then, Lord, we pray for the families that are connected, Lord.
Yes.
I cannot imagine to not be able to see your loved one and to wonder.
Yes.
Father, I pray for them. We as a community pray for the family members that are affected by this. Lord, would you overwhelm them with your kindness? Would you invade their hearts with your goodness? Father, they need reassurance that you are now holding their family members in the palm of your hand.
That's right, Lord.
They need to know, Lord, that you have not forsaken them. Would you visit them in whatever way you could do, Lord, that they would know that it's you? Because they need to know that you're with them, Lord. They need to know that they're not alone, not just in the natural, but in the supernatural, Lord, because man can only do so much, Lord, but you can do anything. You, Lord, can raise joy where there seems to be nothing. If you can bring dead bones to life, Lord, you can bring absolute understanding and wisdom and hope where there isn't any. So I pray over every family member. Lord, for those families that have lost their lives to this, we pray for them, Lord, with the peace that surpasses everything. Would it mount up and guard in their hearts, Lord? Would they know? Because of you, because of the blood of Jesus Christ, there is a hope that is far greater than now. And that the fear that they have doesn't need to be the fear that the world has. Jesus, I pray a blessing over those families, Lord, please. Would you invade every home that is affected? Would you invade every bed that is currently affected by this? And would you, Lord, just rain down a radiant peace, so overwhelming, Lord, that it takes their breath away. We can ask you this because you said we can. Because any name asked with the blood of Jesus Christ, we know will be answered in faith. Help us, Lord, to have understanding to your ways and your will when we don't understand. Help us to believe you, Lord, even when it makes no sense. We trust you, Lord, in the process. And we thank you for every life that is currently represented behind these walls. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, we wish to bless the community of Desert Valley Hospital, Father. I pray that the Lord would bless you and keep you. Would the Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you? I pray that the Lord would turn his face towards you and give you all peace.
Yes.
I pray that because of the name of Jesus Christ, that tonight, Lord, we would see miracles.
That's right.
That we would see hope where there was nothing.
That's right.
But we pray over every single member right now, Lord, in this hospital.
Yes.
We pray over their families, Lord. We ask you to bless them and to protect them. We pray over the family members and the patients, Lord, that you would bless them and keep them, Lord. That your eyes really would shine upon them. That although they are hard-pressed, that they would not be overtaken with discouragement. And although they feel like they're falling, that they will see your hand and pick them up.
Yes.
So, Father, we ask you to bless them. In the name that carries all power, Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. With that, we're going to wish them a Merry Christmas. There is a basket here if you'd like to drop off a card again. If not, we will bless them and applaud them when we're done. Thank you so much for coming.
Wish you a Merry
I didn't hurt your ears, Marlene.
That's it.
Tomorrow we'll be at Victor Valley Hospital if you want to join us at 6 p.m. Signing off. Bye.